In today's video, we'll study a somewhat special series called telescoping series. There are many methods to determine whether an infinite series converges or diverges, but there are not as many series that we can actually find the sum for. We'll learn about telescoping series, which is one such series that allows us to find the sum using the cancellation technique. Here's the first example. Let's find the value of the sum of 2 over 4r squared minus 1 as r goes to from 1 to infinity. When expressing this infinite sum as the limit as n approaches infinity, we can represent it as the sum of 2 over 4r squared minus 1 as r goes to from 1 to n. We aim to transform this infinite sum into a finite sum up to n, simplify the expression, and then utilize the limit as n approaches infinity. Denominator, 4r squared minus 1 can be factored as 2r minus 1 times 2r plus 1. To apply the cancellation technique of the telescoping series, we'll decompose this fraction into partial fractions. Thus, 2 over 2r minus 1 times 2r plus 1 can be expressed as a over 2r minus 1 plus b over 2r plus 1, where a and b are arbitrary constants. I will delve into various cases of partial fraction decomposition in another video. To find the constants a and b, we combine the decomposed fractions back into 1 and compare the resulting numerator with the original numerator, which is 2. The combined numerator is 2ar plus a plus 2br minus b, and the denominator remains 2r minus 1 times 2r plus 1. Rewriting the numerator as a function of r, we have r times 2a plus 2b plus a minus b, and the denominator remains 2r minus 1 times 2r plus 1. This expression for the numerator should be equal to the original numerator, which is 2. Comparing the coefficients of r in both expressions, where the left side can be written as r times 0 plus 2, and the right side as r times 2a plus 2b plus a minus b, we obtain two equations, 2a plus 2b equals 0, which is simplifies to a plus b equals 0 and a minus b is 2. Adding these two equations to eliminate b, we find that 2a is 2, leading to a is 1 and b is negative 1. Shall we substitute the found values of a and b into the above expression? Then we can express it as the limit as n goes to infinity of the sum of 1 over 2r minus 1 minus 1 over 2r plus 1 as r goes from 1 to n. Firstly, let's refrain from applying the limit for now and explore how the sum of 1 over 2r minus 1 minus 1 over 2r plus 1 as r goes to from 1 to n can be expressed more simply. To understand this, let's list a few terms. When r is 1, it becomes 1 over 1 minus 1 over 3. When r is 2, it becomes 1 over 3 minus 1 over 5. And for r equals 3, it becomes 1 over 5 minus 1 over 7. The last term is when r is n, resulting in 1 over 2n minus 1 minus 1 over 2n plus 1. And the second to the last term is when r is n minus 1, yielding 1 over 2 times n minus 1 minus 1 minus 1 over 2 n minus 1 plus 1. If you carefully observe the values on the screen, you will notice a diagonal cancellation pattern. Continuing this process one term at a time, eventually only the first and the last terms remain. Now, let's express the first and the last terms along with the limit. This leads to the limit of 1 minus 1 over 2n plus 1 as n goes to infinity. However, as n approaches infinity, the second term, 1 over 2n plus 1, tends to 0, ultimately resulting in the infinite sum becoming 1. By utilizing the characteristics of telescoping series, we have determined the sum of this infinite sequence. Does this mean that all telescoping series follow this pattern of terms canceling each other out? Let's explore a slightly different example this time. This time, let's examine the example of the sum of 1 over r times r plus 2 as r goes to from 1 to infinity. Similar to the previous method, we'll find the sum from r equals 1 to n, then apply the limit as n approaches to infinity. Furthermore, we'll use partial fraction decomposition to separate 1 over r times r plus 2 into two distinct fractions. To determine the values of the constants a and b, we'll combine two fractions on the right back end 1 and compare coefficients. Then the numerator becomes ar plus 2a plus br, and the denominator is r times r plus 2. If we express the numerator as a function of r, it becomes a plus br plus 2a, and this value should be equal to 1. Writing 1 as 0 times r plus 1, we can compare a plus br plus 2a with the coefficients, revealing that 0 times r should be equal to a plus b times r, and 1 should be equal to 2a. Therefore, we obtain two equations, a plus b equals 0 and 2a is 1, which led to a is 1 over 2 and b is negative 1 over 2. Now, substituting these values for a and b back into the problem, we get as n approaches infinity, the limit of the sum of 1 over 2r minus 1 over 2 times r plus 2 as n goes from 1 to n. Let's simplify and list the terms of the expression highlighted in yellow, the sum of 1 over 2r minus 1 over 2 times r plus 2. When r is 1, it becomes 1 over 2 minus 1 over 6, and when r is 2, it becomes 1 over 4 minus 1 over 8. Similarly, when r is 3, it is 1 over 6 minus 1 over 10. And when r is 4, it is 1 over 8 minus 1 over 12. The last term, when r is n, is 1 over 2n minus 1 over 2 times n plus 2. The second to the last term, when r is n minus 1, is 1 over 2 times n minus 1 minus 1 over 2 times n minus 1 plus 2. And the term before that, when r is n minus 2, is 1 over 2 times n minus 2 minus 1 over 2 times n minus 2 plus 2. Do you notice any patterns? Unlike the first example, this time the 1 over 6 on the right cancels out the 1 over 6 below. The cancellation occurs diagonally, with the positive and negative terms offsetting each other. In the end, only the first two and the last two terms remain. Let me list the terms a bit to the right. The first two and the last two terms, along with the limit, can be written as the limit of 1 over 2 plus 1 over 4 minus 1 over 2 times n minus 1 plus 2 minus 1 over 2 times n plus 2 as n goes to infinity. Simplifying the expression further, it becomes the limit of 3 over 4 minus 1 over 2 times n plus 1 minus 1 over 2 times n plus 2. And as n approaches infinity, the last two terms become 0, leaving only 3 over 4. Today, we explore the telescoping series, a type of infinite series that allows us to find the infinite sum. In the next video, we'll delve into various infinite series and methods to determine their convergence and divergence. If today's video was helpful, please like and subscribe. This concludes the content I prepared for today, and I look forward to meeting you again in the next video. Until then, I've been your math guardian, Alex.